Alright guys, so now we're going to work on these, the injector rails, and they are notorious for breaking or tearing the seals. So we're going to do whatever we can to make sure that doesn't happen. There is another YouTuber, I don't remember the name of his channel, but I might put it here on the screen. And he shows or talks, because something happened to his camera that it doesn't really show it, but he's taking these black seals that are in here off. Because if you leave those black seals there, the injector is not going to be able to sit correctly on the rail. So in order to get this done correctly, we need to pull those seals. Hopefully you see them, those black seals that are in there. We got to pull them out, grease them up, and put it on the injector. Put them right on top, right here. Each one of them. The one down here, I don't know why these are gray, green, and thing his were a different color. I'm not I can't remember correctly, but these green ones here are the ones that have like a little opening, and that is normal. The opening that has is completely normal. The black one that is over here is the one that shouldn't be torn open. It's gotta be closed all around with the obviously the hole in the middle. And he's had to work on this car three times. I mean, not this car specifically, but he's had to work on three different Malibus with the 1.5. The same problem, by the way. The same problem, the vacuum pump. And he's had to replace those seals two out of those three times that he's worked on that engine. Two out of three. So basically it's saying there's a 66% chance that it will tear so far. So I'm gonna do my best to be able to use some grease here, and you know, grease it up a little bit, put on the injector, and then put these rails gently down into its home. It should snap back in place gently, it's not like it slams back inside. It goes in gently. Okay, so let me go get another glove. I don't know why I only got one the first time I came over here. So the reason why I'm using these gloves this time is that I need to be precise with everything that I do. Those other gloves are just too big. This is too big for what I'm gonna do now. Most likely gonna use this or this. Okay, this is gonna be trash. Now, I'm not gonna use this one. I'm gonna use this one. So what I'm gonna do is, obviously, this is cylinder 1, 2, 3, and 4. How do I know this? Because this goes like this. It goes mounted like this. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And I'm gonna put this one on cylinder 1, this one on cylinder 2, so that way I don't mix them up or anything like that. Hopefully this won't cut into it. It's like very tight in there. I don't want to pull too hard on this thing. Apparently these seals are very gentle. Extremely gentle. And this mechanic that I'm mentioning, he apparently has a lot more experience than I do as a mechanic. And he says at the very end of the video that ever since this engine came out, he's had problems putting these rails back in because of the seals. Another reason why this engine sucks. Another reason why this engine is not a good engine to have. Okay. So here you can see the seal. Very, very small. Just don't lose it. It looks fine to me. I don't know. I'm not going to squeeze it. I don't feel like risking it. But it looks fine. So I'm going to put a little bit of grease. Yeah. I guess I should have a napkin. I mean, a paper towel with me this whole time. So put a little grease on it and put it back on the new not on the new but back on the injector. I don't know if I went overkill on the amount of grease that I have, but let's see. Alright. So this goes to cylinder one, which is the one over here. And my hand doesn't really fit in here either. So I'm in the same situation as he is. Okay. It's in. It's in place. Let me clean off some of that excess grease. Okay. I guess you could say fingers crossed. I don't know. I just hope the other three don't break while I'm taking them off. Let's go for cylinder two. Here we go. Okay. They all look okay. They all look okay to me. Well, let's put some grease on this one too. Let's put it on cylinder two. I think it's best if I come in this way. I don't know why. It's like it gives me a better angle. Put it on. There we go. Let's clean off the excess.
Okay, two down, two though. Let's do this. Oh, this one came out very, very easy. I don't know if that's a good sign or a bad sign. I don't know. I don't see it torn, so let's keep on going. Okay, send a three. All right. Now let's do the last one, send a four. I don't see it torn. All right, cylinder four. And in it went. All right. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take these off first before I do anything. I'm gonna put the bolts so they can help me stabilize the situation here. I need a long extension. No, the only way it'll go is down. Actually, on the manual it says to use these and the bottom four to help it sit down. Okay, so that's the procedure. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And it's basically doing one turn at a time.
It's definitely going down. Definitely going down. My back is annoying me. Now that it looks like it's already seated, what I'm gonna do is, I don't know where to put that. Okay. I'm gonna be putting these guys in. Some of these are going to be difficult, and I most likely will not be able to show you how they're going in. Oh, wait. Oh, no. Okay. Alright. I don't need this anymore. Alright.
Okay, what I'm going to do now is what I'm about to do might be considered as overkill, but might as well. I'm going to loosen these out. Now I'm going to use this. Be tying the little ones down there. Doing one turn at a time. Oh, my back. Oh, my back, man. Ugh. Oh, that one got tight. Comes tight. 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 Oh my god. Hand is hurting and my back is hurting from the position that I have to be in. That one's tight. Almost all of them are tight. That one's tight. Now that one's tight. 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 Okay. Whew, that was. That took a minute. Now we can do the same thing with these. Whoa. Okay, tight, and tight. Jeez, man. Okay, so the bottom ones there, those go at 44 inch pound. Same sequence. So okay, you can let go. Okay, and then, okay. The other ones go tightened in 89 foot pounds. So we gotta tighten the bottom ones first. Okay, and then the top ones. All right. So according to that, this should now be tightened correctly. Back is hurting. So I can connect this. Connect to this one and go back in its place. And we have the fuel line coming from back of the engine. We have this. Okay, that goes there. Goes there. Goes there. And this goes here. Okay. This one that goes here. everything through here is connected. Fuel lines connected. Those wires back there connected. So I think I'm at the point where I can go ahead and put this back on. And put this guy on. This goes here, that goes there, and this one goes there. I gotta put these connectors on. I forgot about them. Come on. There we go. Got one more left. Okay. Connectors are in, so now I can go ahead and move these guys out of here. Perfect. Now I did put them in order, so the one on the left set into one. So let's go like that. I guess I could put a little bit of dielectric grease, just a little bit. Man, I think that's all. Next thing will be the battery.